Good morning, everyone. In previous lecture, we had seen the problems regarding model 2 type, wherein availability of similar new machines replaces the older machines. So in that type of examples, we took the cases when items becoming out of date, and because of that, the items become out of date and the new technologies are available or technological advancements are available. So we are replacing the older machines with the newer machines, and we have to decide when we have to replace the machine. And for that, we have discussed a few of the cases which I'm about to show you. In this case, we had seen that machine A and machine B. Machine A is having capital cost 36,000, machine B is having capital cost 40,000, and machine A and machine B, both machine are having scrap value as 0 and 0. So we have calculated that for machine A, we have calculated that machine A can be replaced at the end of 3 years, while in case of machine B can be replaced at the end of 5th year. Now after that, we compared that when to replace machine A by machine B. So for that, we have seen that the average running cost of machine B is 16,000 at the end of 5th year, while on the other end, the running cost of machine A is 8,800 at the end of 2nd year. And on the 3rd year, the average running cost for machine A is kept on increased by 8,000, so it is 16,800 amount, and that is why we took the decision that machine B can be replaced by machine A. So that is what the first example that we have seen so far. Then after, we had seen the case when we have to replace machine A with machine B. Let me show you the data first. Here is the data. In this case, we have been given the case of machine A and its operating cost and its resale value has been given, and we have been given that machine B is better up to 4th years. Machine B should be replaced at the end of 4th year with its best average running cost. We can say lowest average running cost is 3600 were being given in the data. So in this case, we have solved the case of machine A first, wherein we have found out that machine A must be replaced at the end of the 5th year. Machine A must be replaced at the end of 5th year with the average running cost of 4,360 rupees. With the average cost of 4,360 rupees. Now after that, we have been given in the data that what if we are replacing machine A after 2 years with machine B, okay, and whose the replacement time is 4 year and its average cost at the end of 4th year is 3600. Okay, so should we change the equipment A with B? If yes, then when? Okay. So for that, we have seen that in this example, see, for first 2 years we have used. So we have calculated this data for machine A. It's because for machine B, the data has been given that it survives for 4 year with the lowest average cost of 3600. So here we have calculated the separate table for machine A, but after 2nd year, which is, so the year starting in this table is from 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. Now for that, the depreciation cost was the difference of the previous year and the current year. So it is 2500 minus 1250, and likewise for the 2nd year, it is 1250 minus 600, so it is 650, and 600 minus 400 for the 5th year, and for 6th year, it is 400 minus 400, so it would be 0, and likewise for the 7th year, it is 400 minus 400, so it would again 0. And for that, we find out the total cost. Now total cost would be the summation of both of this. Okay, so it is 3550. Then for the next year, it is again 3550. Then after 3600 plus 200, it is 3800, 4500 and 5500. Then we have find out the cumulative cost. Cumulative cost is nothing but the summation of total cost year wise. Okay, so for first year, it is 3550. For the second year, it is the summation of these two. For the third year, it is the summation of all the 3 years total cost. Likewise, for fourth year, it is 15,400 for the cumulative cost for the fourth year, and likewise for fifth year. And from this, we find out, here it is 3550 divided by 1. Here it is 71 cumulative cost divided by 2, since we are getting for the 2 year. Here for the 3 year, so it is 1090 divided by 3. Here it is 15,400 divided by 4. And here it is 20,900 divided by 5. Because it is first year, second year, third year, fourth year and fifth year after the third year. Okay, so we have to divide this value in this manner. Now, after that we have concluded that since for the third year of machine A, the average running cost is 3550. For the fourth year, the average running cost is 3550 again. So it is better to utilize machine A for third year as well as for fourth year, because both the year the average running cost comes the same value. So rather than changing it after third year, it would be better, a wise decision to utilize it for the one more year, which is fourth year. Okay. Now after that, for fifth year, what we have observed that machine A, the average cost for machine A is 3633. That 3633 value, 3,333 value is greater than the 3600 of average running cost of machine B, which was given in data. So it is greater than that of the 3600 of average running cost for machine B. So that is why we took the decision that it is better to replace the machine at the end of fourth year. Machine A must be replaced by machine B at the fourth year. But if we are comparing for machine A only, then it is advisable to replace it at the end of fifth year. So here we are getting that after while comparing one machine with the other, we come to know that it is better to replace machine in the earlier stage. Okay, if it is if we are just representing the data for only one machine, then the decision was fifth year. But if we are comparing the data of machine A with the average running cost of machine B, then we can see that the data represents the the machine A must be replaced 1 year ahead than that of the other machine. And one more thing, that average running cost for that is 3550, but it is comparison with the machine B whose running cost is 3600. So that is what so far we have seen regarding model 2. Now before starting model 3, which is of present work factor, if you are facing any question or any queries, please ask it so that we will solve for the model problems related to model 2. Then we will proceed solving the model 3. If you have any doubt, you can unmute your mic and you can discuss. Else we can continue with the next problem, which is model 3. Any doubt with the model? Tulas, unmute your mic so that we can discuss your question.
Good morning, sir.
Good morning. Where you are getting the problem? Depreciation.
Sir, in the depreciation cost of second table.
Yeah, in the second table. Yeah. Let me clarify that. This table is for machine A, but machine A after 2 years. Okay. we have made this table for not for machine B, because and last lecture one or two students got confused that it is for table B. No, there is no such table B. For table B, we have been given direct value that average running cost for machine B is 3600, and we have to replace the machine B at every fourth year. Okay, so that is what the data. There is no such table for given for the machine B. Now regarding depreciation cost, in table A, the depreciation cost for the first year it is 5000. For the second year, it is 2500. For the third year, it is 12,500, and likewise up to 7 years. But here in the second table, how we have to do, because we are starting with the third year. Okay, so with the third year, here we have to compare within these two. So it is 2500 minus 12,500. So that is why it is 12,500. So here you have to calculate in such a manner that previous year's scrap value minus current year scrap value. So that is the net depreciation cost. Because we already consider all these value. We have calculated 5000 and 2500 in previous year also. Okay. And one more way that you can understand that if we wanted to find out this value, the third year depreciation cost, which is 8750 in the third year. So if you wanted to have net value, it would be the difference between these two. So it is 8750 minus 7500. If you do this, 8750 minus 7500, it would be 12,500. Getting it?
Okay.
Now for the next year, if you want to calculate out, it is 9400 minus 8750. I think there is some mistake in this. So this is how you can calculate. Are you getting it?
Yes, sir.
So it is the difference between the current year and previous year. And if you can see here, 9400, 9600. Okay. So that is
the
difference for fifth year. That is, we have 9600. It is zero. And for the last year, it is 00.
Okay, sir.
Any more doubt from anyone else? Yes, here it is 650 that you can see for the fourth year. Okay. Okay, now let us start with the third model, which is present, which is based on the time value of money, Can anybody give me the example of time value of money? Can anyone give us the example? We have discussed this in this first or second lecture. What do you mean by time value of money? Just unmute your mic and you can answer it. Give me the example of time value of money, wherein we can see the changes of value, changes of time over the years, or changes the value of money over the time. Now let me give you the example. Now suppose that if I wanted to invest 1 lakh rupees, if I'm investing
1 lakh rupees in the current year. Okay. Now I would be happy to know that what my investment would be after 10 years. Okay. And for that, we are calculating sometimes the discount rate, or sometimes we are calling it a word inflation rate. Okay. So inflation rate is the rate by which the value of money increases. Inflation rate is the rate by which the value of money increases. Does anybody know the current rate of inflation in India? Because sometimes it is essential to learn this inflation rate while starting the current value or present value of money, which is time based value of money. Anybody have any idea related to current inflation rate of India? I just told the definition of inflation rate, that is the rate at which the value of money is getting increased. Okay. Nitin said it is 4 to 5%. Yes, exactly. It is 4.86% for the 2019-20 year. Okay. And now 2020-21 government has not declared the inflation rate, but we will be getting it soon. Okay. Previous year it was 2.8, and the previous year it was again 4.8 or 4.75 something. So it is a rate by which the money value of money increases. Now if I'm investing 1 lakh rupees, if I'm investing 1 lakh rupees for first year, okay, and let us say that the rate of inflation or rate of interest or rate of depreciation all could be the same, but we are using it for the different terms in the different cases, but all the meaning of all the cases are same. Now can anyone tell me that investing 1 lakh rupees in the current year with the inflation rate of, let us say, round of taking the value 10%, what would be the value after 1 year of my current investment, which is of 1 lakh rupee? Can anybody count on that? Currently investing 1 lakh rupees and inflation rate I am talking about 10%, so how much I will able to get after 1 year? Are you getting the question? Yes, Tulas, it is right. It is 1 lakh rupees of investment and 10% of 1 lakh amount, that would be 10,000. So it is at the end of first year, it will be 1 lakh 10,000. Yes, Nitish, you are also right. So are you getting the rate at which inflation increases? Now, suppose that if I'm investing 1 lakh rupees for the current year, and I wanted to find out its value after 10 years. Okay. I have to find out its current value after 10 years. So we have to use certain equation, and how the equation is getting calculated, that is just displayed on the screen. And let me explain one by one. Yes, Bhavya, you are also right. It is 1,10,000 for the next year. But here we are talking about so many numbers of years. So it is like kept on increasing year by year. Okay, now let us say that P1, okay, P for first year, so principal amount for first year, and P stands for principal amount, and I stands for interest over the years. Okay, so let us say that if I'm investing 1 lakh rupees, if I'm investing 1 lakh rupees, which is principal amount, with the inflation or interest, with the inflation or the interest, okay, we are calling it as an I percentage, and multiplied by P. So the calculation that you have made for that, P stands for 1 lakh rupees, I stands for 10%, and again P stands for 10% of the principal amount. Okay. So that is how you will calculate it, that it is 1 lakh plus 10% of 1 lakh, 10% of 1 lakh, which is 10,000. So it is 1 lakh 10,000. So you are successfully calculated for the first year. Now let us calculate it for the second year. So for second year, how much it would be? It is the, that interest is being applied to the principal amount or total amount of the after the end of first year, not the principal amount directly. So it is P1, which is the cost after first year, plus ith percentage after P1 year or the previous year. Okay, so it is P1 plus I plus P1. So it, if we kept P1 common, then the, it is equivalent to P1 into the bracket 1 plus I. Okay, so from this P1 kept common, so here 1 will be common and here I will be common. So it is P1 into the bracket 1 plus I, which is equivalent to here if we are putting the value of P1, which is P into 1 plus I. So putting the value of P1 in this equation, which is P into 1 plus I into, we have already 1 plus I there. So it is 1 plus I. So it is P2 is equals to P 1 plus I square. Now anybody can calculate what would be the value of 1 lakh with interest or inflation rate 10% for the next year. Can anyone give the value? The value of 1 lakh after second year. Yes, exactly. It is not only 1,20,000, but it is 1,21,000. First, you are getting some mistake. It is 1,21,000. Dhawal, Tulash and others are right. Because it is P2, which is the net sum value at the end of second year, it is equivalent to P, which is 1 lakh into 1 plus I, that is 1 plus 1.1. It is square of 1.1. So it is 1 lakh plus 21,000. So it is 1,21,000. Okay. So that is what the future value at the end of second year. So likewise, if it is 10 years, so it is P10. P10 is equals to P into 1 plus I to the power 10. P10 is equals to P into bracket 1 plus I. And to the power 10. Ready? So that is how we can say that at the end of F year, which is final year, or we can say future worth of money, okay, or worth of money in future is equivalent to P. Okay, P is, that is principal amount into the bracket 1 plus I, 1 plus I rest to N, where N is the number at which we wanted to calculate the value. Now, from this equation, we can say that P, that is principal amount, or we can call it a present worth. So it is P is equals to F divided by 1 plus I rest to N. So it is P is equals to F divided by 1 plus I rest to N, just modifying this equation into this form. So that we can get that F is equals to P is equals to F 1 plus I rest to minus N, since this bracket is moving from denominator to numerator. So F into 1 plus I rest to minus 1, which is P. And to that we can call that P is equals to F into present worth factor. Here 1 plus I to the power minus N is being known as present worth factor, because it is the factor by which the value is kept on changing. It is the factor by which the value is getting changed. And here the slight mistake is that you just have to write minus N. Here you just have to write 1 plus I rest to minus N, because here it is minus N. So here it is 1 plus I rest to minus N is equals to the present worth factor. Okay, where if the N is equals to 1, then present worth factor is given by D is equals to, D is the depreciation rate, or we can say the inflation rate, or whatever term, interest rate that you wanted to call out. So it is the depreciation rate is equals to 1 plus I to the power minus 1, 1 to the power minus 1. But make sure that here is the minus N, that is the printing mistake or typing mistake. It is 1 plus IRS 2 minus 1. Now, any doubt within this? Yes, double. It is 2,59,374. Exactly. Any doubt within this theoretical part? This is how we will calculate the depreciation rate or discount rate, whatever you wanted to call. Okay, now let's see the numerical. Just take a screenshot or note down this data. In this example, we have been given that a firm pays 10,000 rupees for its equipment, which means that capital cost of the machines or equipment is 10,000 rupees, or we can call a principal amount is 10,000 rupees. Their operating and maintenance cost are about 2,500 per year for first 2 years. So for first 2 year, maintenance cost is fixed, which is 2,500 rupees. Sorry, it is 2,500 per year. So for first year and second year, it is 2,500 for first year. Same way, 2,500 for second year. Now after that, that value is kept on increasing by 1,500 rupees every year. So for third year onwards, the value is kept on increasing 1,500 every year. Okay. When such equipment should be replaced? First, you have to learn up to this. So when we should replace the equipment? Okay. The discount rate we will be considering in the second part, so that we will be learning the difference between the two cases. Now, once you have the data, just prepare the table. Just for the first year, can anyone tell me how much is the operating cost? Just prepare the table like this and tell. Let me know. Yes, what that would be? Operating cost for the first year.
2,500.
Okay, for the next year.
Same.
For the next, how much it would be? Sorry.
First 2 years same. 2,500.
Okay. Third year.
Third year 1,500.
No, that is wrong.
4,000.
We are increasing.
2,500 plus 1,500.
Yes, it is 2,500 and the increment in is 1,500. So it is 4,000. For the fourth year. For the fourth year, how much it would be?
No.
4,000 plus again increment. Yes. Then again in increment in previous year by 1,500. Are you getting it?
7,000.
Okay, it is 7,000 and in increment in previous year by again 1500. So at the end of 6 years,
8500.
Okay. So we have this value. Now prepare the table and let me know the year at which we must replace the machine with the model one. We are solving it with model one as of now. Then after we will solve the example in the regular manner with the model three. Okay. So that we can compare the exact value. Just solve the example and find out the year at which you have to replace the machine and put that on chat box.
If anyone is facing problem within this simple problem, just let me know. I will try to help you.
सर स्क्रैप वैल्यू में
स्क्रैप वैल्यू आप पहले नदीन स्क्रैप वैल्यू ना पहले वाला जीरो ले लवाने सो स्क्रैप वैल्यू वुड बी जीरो
तो डिप्रीशिएशन कॉस्ट
सेम अज ये ना डिप्रीशिएशन कॉस्ट इज द डिफरेंस बिटवीन कैपिटल कॉस्ट माइनस स्क्रैप वैल्यू
ये तो सेम अज
ये यस इट वुड रिमेन सेम
यस सर
Fourth year, sir.
Okay. What about other? So it would be fourth year or third year?
Sir, depreciation cost mein 10,000.
Sir, after 4 years.
Oh, sorry.
After 4 years.
10,000. Sorry, that is my mistake. So we must replace the machine at the end of 4th year.
After 4 years. End of 4 years.
At the end or after 4th year. Ready? Everyone are getting the same answer? Okay. Now, for this example, just we have sold conventionally, I would say it is like the aging of machine, which is model 1, wherein we are considering scrap cost as 0. Depreciation cost is, it caps on constant. So, and we are not considering the value of money, which changes over time. So this is like the example which solves normally. Okay. Any doubt within this? We have sold it using model 1 so that we can compare it. What if we are considering the depreciation? Now let us have a look at that. Okay. Now, let us have the look at this. Okay, now let us start solving the example same way. For the first year, it is 2500. For second year, it is 2500. For third year, it is 2500 plus 1500, 4000 plus 5000, 1500, then 7000 and 8500. Now, we have been given in data that capital cost is 10,000. The interest or inflation rate, we can say it is 10%, so it is 0.1. Now, if we calculate discount rate for the first year, discount rate is D is equals to 1 divided by 1 plus I whole rest to N, which is N percentage.
Sir, repeat karo na kai khabar na padi.
Ek kaj minute. Just moment.
Sir, N શું છે?
N is the number of year. Okay, so that, see,
where I is
inflation rate, 10% or interest rate. Apne data ma apelu. See, let me show the data first. See, in this data, up to now we skip the last line. In the last line, what it is given, that the discount rate is given per year, it is 10%. So every year the value of money kept on increasing by 10%. Now, is that clear up to this?
Okay, sir.
Yes. And one more thing, in the previous slide, if we see, we have got the equation that 1 plus I rest to minus 1, or we can say that it is 1 over 1 plus I rest to minus N. Is that clear up to this? So that is what the equation that we have to use. Now in this equation, the equation is 1 plus 1 divided by 1 plus I rest to N. So that is what the equation that we are using it. Now let me start with solving the first example. Can anyone tell me what is the running cost? It is 2500 for the first year. Now discount rate. Can anyone tell me what could be the discount rate for first year?
10%.
Discounted factor.
D equal to, sir.
Yes. How much it would be? Any guess?
Sir, first year mate to same aj aave.
Yes, for first year it would
0.909.
Be 0.909. That is why we can say that the factor is
0.9091.
That is what the question is. 0.9091, that is after first year. So 0.9091 is starting from the second year. So after 1 year, the next year the cost would be like that. And here what we are talking about during the entire first year. So that is why the discounted factor D for the first year it would be 1. Is that clear?
Yes.
Okay, sir.
So the discount rate factor for first year it would be 1. Okay. Now same way we have to calculate all the other values. Let me put the all the values of running cost. It is 2500, 4000, 5500, 7000, and 8500. Now what is the discount rate at the end of second year? So for that n would be 1, because for one, because for second year first year has been passed. So for the next year how much it would be? So for that, you have to calculate 1 divided by 1 plus I raised to 1 for the previous year, because 1 year has been passed and we are calculating it for the second year. So it is 1 divided by 1 plus I raised to 1. So it is, that value is 0.9091. Similar, can
zero.
You? Yes. Mm. Similarly, calculate.
0.9090.
Yeah, that's fine. Calculate it for the third, fourth, fifth and sixth year and let me know the value.
Okay, sir.
For the third year n would be 2, for the fourth year n would be third year.
Sir, 0.8264.
Okay.
Third year mate 0.7513.
0.7513. Okay.
Point six eight three zero. Point 0.6209.
Okay. 0.6209. Okay. Everyone are getting the same value?
0.641.
Okay, sir, same value.
Ready. Okay. Now we have to calculate discounted running cost. In order to calculate discounted running cost, it is the product of second and third column. So for first column, it is 2500 into discounted factor. So that is discounted running cost. Okay. It is the product of 4000 multiplied by 0.8264. Then for the next year, it is 5500 into 0.7513 for the next year.
getting it up to this, solve it up to here. I will wait for a minute, then we will proceed for filling the other columns.
Sir, done.
Done, sir.
Okay. Now we have to find out discounted cumulative running cost. So for first year it is 2500 itself. Now since it is cumulative, it is the current year plus all the previous years. All of you please calculate along with me so that you will be able to get answer correctly. Now can anyone share me what the depreciation cost would be?
$10,000.
So total cost minus scrap value is zero.
Scrap value is zero, perfect. So it is 10,000. Yes, it is 10,000. Solve it up to the year.
Yes, sir.
Okay, done up to here.
Okay, sir, done.
Okay, now total discounted cost would be how much? It is the summation of depreciation cost. Total discounted cost is nothing but total depreciation cost plus the discounted cumulative value. Okay, so it is 10,000 plus 2,500. So it is that way you can calculate all this value. Just calculate total discounted value. Done up to this.
Okay, sir, done.
Now cumulative discounted factor. Now cumulative discount factor is the discounted factor summation year wise. So for first year it is 1, for next year it is 0.9091 plus previous also it is 1.9091. Likewise for the other years you can calculate current year plus all the previous years summation. Okay, now average cost would be, now the average cost would be the ratio of total discounted cost, the ratio of total discounted cost divided by cumulative discounted factor. Okay, so it is the total ratio of total discounted cost divided by cumulative discounted factor. Are you getting the answer? Or the speed is going up? Now, can anyone share me the answer that at which year we supposed to change the machine? Okay. So again, we are getting the same answer that we must change the machine at the end of fourth year because the average running cost considering depreciation would be 6,370 rupees approximately, and it comes at the fourth year, and next year the cost is getting increasing, so we must change the machine after fourth year. Here, can anybody give me the difference between these two answers? If we consider depreciation, the average cost is 6,369, which is approximately 6,370 rupees. On the other hand, if we ignore the depreciation, the average running cost would be 6,125 rupees. Can anyone share what is the difference between these two and which could be preferred, with depreciation or without depreciation?
244.88, sir.
That is the difference. No, I'm not saying. I'm saying in that sense, okay, what the difference does it make? Not in numbers. Which one should be preferred and which one is not? Should we consider depreciation or should we not, based on this data?
Sir.
Yes.
Hello.
Yes, yes.
Sir, depreciation consider kariye to average cost vadhare aave che comparatively. Okay. Je depreciation consider nahi karta ena compare ma.
Okay. So that is the clear that we can see, and obviously it would be depreciation. If we consider the cost, obviously it would increase. So should we consider we increase the cost or should we should not? That is the question.
Sir, repeat. last month.
The question is that should we consider depreciation even though it gives the increase in the running average cost, or should we ignore the depreciation cost and we have to calculate without considering depreciation? Which one is advisable for any industry? Are you getting the question?
Okay, sir.
Sir, including depreciation cost.
Yes, we must consider the cost which includes the depreciation. Why? Because time value of money changes over time. So we must consider it rather than ignoring. So it is essential to consider the cost of machine considering depreciation, because the machine runs over n numbers of years. So we cannot ignore the changes of value over time. So it is essential to consider it. Okay. And that is why we have compared that without depreciation it is 6,125. Okay. And with depreciation it is 6,370 rupees approximately. So here the difference that it makes. Okay. But for this case, we unfortunately we got the same year number of years by which we can change the machine. So that's it from my side for today's session. And for today's session, we considered the third model, wherein the changes of money over time, the changes of money value with respect to time that we have seen. And that is what the difference in answer. Because if we ignore the depreciation, the average running cost would be lesser, but it is not the actual data. The actual data is with the depreciation cost, because it gives the actual value that after investing 10,000 in this year in the capital machines, after fourth year, the value of that increases in certain numbers. So it is that value. Okay.
Sir.
Yes.
If a discount rate is changed, then after we replace the machine after 4 years, the value is changed.
Hello, I didn't get last part. Yes, value is changing.
Average running cost value is changing.
Yes, and why? Because the value of 10,000 meanings is changing after C. If you look at this, just look at the cursor. For the first year, entire first year, the value of running cost 2500 remains same. Okay, but after second year, the value of 2500 is getting reduced by some value, and the final value of 25,000 is equivalent after 1 year to 2272 rupees. So that is why it is being essential to learn this. Getting it?
Okay, sir.
हाँ, 2500 रुपया नहीं value चाहिए ना, 2272 रुपया थी कि एक वर्ष पच्ची ले value घटी, तो ये value घटी तो सुधा है तुम्हारी average cost बढ़ से? So just that's it from my side for today's session. Hope you have learned a lot in today's session and put your attendance on chat box. Have a nice day. Do not forget to mark your attendance. It is essential to put that in this chat box only. Do not send me in person, please.
Sir. Hello.
Yes.
Sir, એવું ક્યારે બની શકે કે આપણે ફર્સ્ટ ટાઈમ આપણે જે એટલે મોડેલ 1 થી આપણે સમ કરેલો એમાં રિપ્લેસ મશીન આફ્ટર 4 યર છે.
હા.
એન્ડ ધેન આપણે ડિસ્કાઉન્ટ રેટ 10% કન્સિડર કર્યું. ત્યારે આપણે મશીન ચેન્જ 4 યર બે આન્સર સેમ આવ્યો 4 યર આફ્ટર
યસ
એવું ક્યારે બની શકે કે આન્સર અલગ અલગ આવે
યસ વેન વી ચેન્જ ધ ડેપ્રિસિએશન કોસ્ટ એન્ડ વેન વી આર કમ્પેરિંગ મશીન એ વિથ મશીન બી ઇન ધેટ કેસ ઇટ વિલ ચેન્જ વાય બીકોઝ ઇન મશીન કમ્પેર વાઇલ કમ્પેરિંગ ટુ મશીન મશીન બીઝ એવરેજ રનિંગ કોસ્ટ વિથ ધ રનિંગ કોસ્ટ ઓફ મશીન એ નાઉ લેટ મી શો યુ ધ અધર એક્ઝામ્પલ્સ not in this yes in this case if we are comparing the average running cost of this machine with respect to this machine running cost okay now let us say that instead of 6000 if you consider depreciation it would give you 17000 here at the cursor location you will see that it is 17000 so while comparing it with the running cost of machine A okay hello while comparing that average running cost which is 17000 with respect to third year's running cost which is lesser so we would replace not at third year we would change it to the fourth year are you getting it